And so we are here, all of us, staring at you, and very happy to take any questions you have to any one of us in the house.
Okay,
thank
Raja
you.
Rajamouli, sir. Sir, here. Yeah. Rajamouli, sir. Congratulations for the trailer. It looks epic. My question to you is, I really admire your vision, first of all. My question to you is that, how much time did it really took to conceptualize and to write down, and then Karan sir said that it was 380 days of shoot, but even before that, how many total months or amount of year it took for Bahubali to came on screen?
Thank you very much. And surprisingly, the story part took, we finished it quite quickly. 2.5 months to 3 months, we had the whole script on our hands. But from then onwards, doing the concept sketches, doing the pre-visualization work, setting up the locations, building the sets, it took the whole 2.5 years because we were continuously doing. We took almost 1 year for the pre-production. But even after the shooting started, we kept on doing. In fact, the concept artists who started at the beginning of the film, even after the shooting is over 3 months back, they are still in our office working on the visual effects look and feel of the film.
Karan, जहाँ तक हम आपकी फिल्मों की बात करें, बड़े-बड़े locations होते हैं, बड़े-बड़े
वो कहाँ पहले? Sorry.
Family drama होती है.
जी.
ये फिल्म ने ऐसा क्या आपको convince किया कि आप इसे
देखिए कन्विंस करने की जरूरत नाम सुन के मैं कन्विंस हो गया. इनका काम मैं बहुत देख चुका हूँ, बहुत सराह चुका हूँ और बेहद मोहब्बत है मुझे इनके काम के साथ. तो जब मैंने इनकी जो फिल्म देखी थी ईगा, तो मैं पूरा पागल हो गया क्योंकि मक्खी पे पूरी पिक्चर बनाना, या बड़े बड़े सितारों के साथ हम कभी कभी गलत पिक्चर बना लेते हैं, एक मक्खी के ऊपर एक पूरी पिक्चर बनाना और कन्विंसिंगली बताना, वहाँ इमोशंस डालना और वो सब एक कहानी दौर बताना, ये काम सिर्फ एक जीनियस कर सकता है. तो जब राणा का फोन मुझे आया था, उन्होंने कहा कि ये उनकी विजन है, मैंने फिर से सुन चुका था कि ये ऐसी फिल्म बन रही थी और हिंदुस्तान की सबसे बड़ी पिक्चर बन रही है. बड़ी स्केल की बात नहीं कर रहा क्यों, हम सब बहुत पैसे खर्च करते हैं, लेकिन उन पैसों को सही ढंग से खर्च करना और उस विजन को इस स्केल पे दिखाना और जहाँ एक इमोशनल ग्राफ भी हो, ऐसी फिल्में बहुत कम बनती हैं, शायद बनी ही नहीं हिंदुस्तान में. मैंने ये विजन, मैं ज़्यादा कहूँगा तो लोग कहेंगे कि मैं पागल हो चुका हूँ, लेकिन ऐसी विजन मैंने मुगले आजम में देखी है जिसमें एक इमोशनल है, कनेक्ट है और एक स्केल और ऑप्यूलेंस है. उसके बाद मैंने शायद ही मुझे ऐसी मटीरियल मैंने देखी हो जिसने मुझे पर्सनली इतना इमोशनली चार्ज किया है. तो आई वॉज सो, जैसे कि द फेमस लाइन इन हॉलीवुड सेज ही हैड मी एट हेलो, दिस टाइम राणा हैड मी एट राजमौली. जैसे राजमौली ऐसे आई एम ऑन, पुट माई नेम एनी वे यू वॉन्ट ऑन दिस फिल्म. मैं कहीं भी, मैं लास्ट क्रेडिट पे भी नाम डाल देते, मैं बहुत खुश हो जाता. देखो क्या होता है कि किसी ने इतनी मेहनत की और हम चढ़ जाए क्रेडिट खाने, हम बहुत अच्छे हैं इस डिपार्टमेंट में.
करण सर यो. हाँ करण सर, आई लाइक टू टेल यू दैट इट्स वेरी गुड दैट यू आर प्रेजेंटिंग दिस मूवी. My question to you is that जितनी epic ये movie बनी है, why do you think that Bollywood has not made such an epic movie on such large scale? जो that looks so promising, Bahubali.
We and don't have him, no. We don't have him. Where is the Rajamouli in India? We don't have him. Simple answer. We had a man with this vision and somebody who would put his life just on edge for over 3 years and not care about anything else in the world but that cinema. I'm not that filmmaker and I know nobody else is either. We don't have him. It's as simple as that.
Okay, sir. What have you learned from Rajamouli, sir? By being with this project, what have you learned from
him? To stop judging reality shows and start making movies. That is what I have learned.
Karan, do you agree that we always look up to the South? Directors?
Yes, sorry?
Yeah. Karan, do you agree that we always look up to the South directors for, new subject or good films?
You know, there's always a divide, you know, like if you stay in the city of Mumbai, you'll always say, oh, Mumbai is so much cooler than Delhi. Everything, there's a certain debate that always kind of crowds us at various levels of conversation. Similarly, the debate between, I spent a lot of time with Ravi Chandran, he was a cinematographer of My Name is Khan, and he told me so much, and you know, there is so much we've heard always about the content being so great down south. And I just think it's the discipline, And it's the single-mindedness that I think some of our some members of our fraternity lack. You know, we start chasing box office numbers by and too much dependence sometimes on movie stars by realizing that content is king. And when will we finally accept it? This year, it has been more than decided that it's only content that eventually sells. Stars notwithstanding, the success in the recent months of Piku and Tanu Vets Manu, and now Dil Dhadakne Do that's releasing in Friday, which I believe is an outstanding film. It just goes to show that an audience eventually may not come on hordes on day one, but you give them a great film, your weekend will be packed. No doubt about that. I believe that Hindi cinema particularly is weak on its writing department. And I think that's where we need to really pull up our socks, is our writing. We have inadequate writing resources because we don't empower our writers. When we do that, we'll make greater films.
Karan, abhi aapne kaha ki Rajmouli sir ne aalok kiya aapke write mein. Ki इन्होंने बोला कि आप रियलिटी शो जज मत करिए फिल्म बनाइए तो क्या आप ऐसा करने वाले हैं अभी
इन्होंने नहीं कहा मैंने खुद ये ठान लिया
तो आपने बंद कर मतलब नहीं करें
नहीं अभी तो नहीं ना मैं बीच शो में थोड़ी मैं निकल सकता हूँ शोज के बीच में उन बेचारे कंटेस्टेंट्स का क्या होगा बीच में जो जज ही चला गया भाग गया
सवाल ये है कि बी अल्फाबेट आजकल काफी आपके साथ लगा हुआ है बॉम्बे वेलवेट then brothers is coming then bahubali to ek zamana tha jab k aata tha abhi b hai to isko
ab dusre alphabets ko bura lag raha tha na to isliye maine socha ke unki kya galti thi k ko zyada importance de diya b pe main chad gaya hu
karan mera sawal aise hai ki ab hindi mein please bata de ki kis tarike ki kahani hai kyunki इस फिल्म में एग्जैक्टली होने क्या वाला
है आपको कहानी क्यों बताया हम आप पिक्चर आके देखिए थोड़ा एक हां आप प्लीज देखिए ये वुड यू लाइक टू शेयर एज मच ऑफ द नैरेटिव एज यू कैन सर क्योंकि ये मेरा हक नहीं है कि मैं कहानी बताऊं ये हक इनका है
आई वुड लाइक टू बट आई वाज नॉट प्रिपेयर्ड टू डू दैट एंड आई हैव गिवन दिस विजुअल एंड आई डोंट वांट टू यू नो स्पॉइल दैट विद माय नैरेटिव at this moment of time but as we progress into our interviews which we will be going to do a lot I think I'll give more insight into the film
Rajmouli I was reading somewhere here Lipika I was reading somewhere that this film is touted to be the biggest film of the decade astrologically numerologically what do you have to say
yeah it is yeah, it is in a sense the budget wise the making wise I cannot exactly say it is it because I don't know what are the budgets of the other films but as far as I know if you take off the stars and the director's remunerations out of the production I think this is by far the costliest production ever made
Rajmouli sir idhar Prashant ETV se aapke मैंने आपका काम मगिदरा के वक्त मैं हैदराबाद में था और रामोजी फिल्म सिटी में जब आप शूट कर रहे थे उस बड़े पैमाने पर तब मैंने देखा हुआ है एक इमोशनल कनेक्ट है और आपको जब राजमौली सर लोग कहते हैं तो वो आपका काम बताता है ये फिल्म एक तरह से बहुत सारी चीज़ों को लेकर है और राइटिंग की जैसी तारीफ की कितना इमोशनल सफ़र रहा क्योंकि फिल्मों के साथ एक इमोशनल कनेक्ट आपका जुड़ा हुआ है
What was your emotional journey while spending 380 days and 3 years? What were your personal beats while you went through the process of making Bahubali?
Like I said in my speech, this is the world that I have been.
My apologies.
Okay, this is the film that I have been. This is the world that I have been living in, not just dreaming of. And this is a very difficult world to construct. It is not. It just doesn't happen in one day. We keep on building brick by brick, and it is not my money that I am building it with. No, it is the producer's money, and I need to. I have a moral responsibility towards them. So these are contradictive emotions. When you see the budget is going up on one side, and I'm putting some other's money in the front, and at the same time I'm seeing my dream, my world being built. These are two emotions, and on top of that, I'm spending less and less time with my family. But I should thank my wife, Rama, who was very supportive and very understanding. She not only did the costumes for this film, she not only designed the looks and costumes for the film, she was my backbone. She made me walk, and she made me stand up, and she made my world of Bahubali become true. So I had a lot of emotions going through me, and the emotions are contradictory to one another. But more than the emotion, it is because of these people which I who made my world come true.
Prabhas, आपसे जी जी या प्रभास आपसे सवाल है कि जिस तरह का सिनेमा आप कर रहे थे, बहुत ही मेनस्ट्रीम सिनेमा था, और वो सब छोड़ के आपने एक फिल्म में पूरी जान लगा दी. स्क्रिप्ट इतनी कन्विक्शन के साथ राजमौली सर लेके आए थे या आप करना चाहते थे राजमौली के साथ काम?
I wanted to work with Rajmouli. I already did 10 years before film called Chhatrapati, and five, 6 years before he told me about, like, I'm going to do a very big film with you. 4 years before, 3.5 years before, he said, we're doing this script called Bahubali. And I'm so excited. And he told me, like, it'll take a lot of time. And you know, this is once in a lifetime film. You can't get it again. And I'm lucky to be part of this film, and I want to do it. Thank you.
Karan, this question is for you. I am Prema. I'm coming from a news channel in Telugu, down south. And I'm proud to say that Rajamouli is our director. He's one of the brilliant directors of our times. He's made 10 films, and this is the 10th film. All his 9 films are blockbuster hits. And you have been the finest director and producer of Bollywood. I just wanted to know one thing, very curious. You've been telling so many things about Rajamouli, but I'm curious to know, what are those senses and sensibilities, those real emotions that really triggered you as the director? In a director's point of view, what is it that you really admire in Rajamouli?
You know, more than anything else, it's, how do I put it? Whenever I've seen his films, there is a certain kind of feel and the drama that is generated that he has inherently in his writing. I think he balances technology with emotion in a way and makes it so exceptionally audience friendly in a way I haven't seen any filmmaker do. You know, each filmmaker has a certain strength. When you look at Imtiaz Ali, there's always kind of some, there's great conversational writing. Zoya Akhtar, who gets into the depths of relationships. Raju Irani, who taps into a socialist issue and gives it a certain kind of cinematic vision. Each filmmaker has a specific strength. Very few filmmakers integrate emotion with updated technology and yet makes it so largely for an audience without apologizing about it in any way. And integrating the three of these elements together, I think only Rajamouli has had that vision to do. So whether it's been in Magadira or it's been in Iga or now in Bahubali, and I haven't seen Student Number One, but I'm sure it's exceptional as well. But I think there's the integration of emotion, of an audience, and of updated technology. And I believe that sometimes you can just make a great technically solid film, but it could lack soul, or you could make a super solid, soulful film, but it may not have the cinematic vision. He combines these forces, and that's why he's a force to reckon with.
Karan sir, Hindi cinema ka zaman, daur aaj badal chuka hai, realistic cinema ka zaman aa gaya. Aap as a producer point of view se, kaun se parameters pe film ko dekhte hain, kyun main ise produce karun?
देखिए भाई, मैं कभी कैटेगराइज तो करता नहीं क्या पैरेलल है, क्या कमर्शियल है, क्या रियल है, क्या अनरियल है. मैं हिंदी फिल्म का बच्चा हूँ. जब से मैं जानता हूँ, जब से मुझे याद है, मैं हिंदी फिल्मों से बिल्कुल मैं पागल होता था. मैं पिक्चरों को 5 या 10 बार देखता था. तो मैं पूरी तरह मैं ऑडियंस हूँ. मैं रोता हूँ, मैं हंसता हूँ, मैं नाचता हूँ, मैं गाता हूँ जब मैं पिक्चर देखता हूँ. तो मुझे अगर ये सारे एलिमेंट्स मिल जाते पिक्चर में और मैं टच आई वॉक आउट फीलिंग कि एक इमोशन है मेरे दिल में. जब रिसेंटली मैंने पीकू देखी तो मुझे अपने बाप की याद आई. टच मी पर्सनली, जब मैंने तनु एज मनु देखी तो मैं हंस हंस के पागल हो गया. तो मैं सिनेमा के बाहर जब आता हूँ तो एक इमोशन के साथ मुझे एग्जिट करना होता है. तब मुझे पता चल जाता है कि मुझे ये पिक्चर अच्छी लगी या नहीं. एंड आई फील इट्स ऑल अबाउट दैट. यू हैव टू, तो मैं कोई कैटेगरीज से मैं जाता नहीं. मुझे अगर मैं स्क्रिप्ट पढ़ता हूँ और मुझे छू ले या मुझे एंटरटेन करे तो मैं वो पिक्चर बना लेता हूँ. सो आई रिएक्ट I don't react as a filmmaker. I react as a cinegoer when I look at a film. I'm an audience. I'm a paying audience, and that I want to be satisfied. When I'm not, I'm disappointed. When I am, I'm ecstatic. It's as simple as that.
Is the film inspired by Mahabharat?
Is it inspired by Mahabharat.
Is the film inspired by Mahabharat or are there any references to it?
Yes, a lot of it has been inspired by Mahabharat. Not just this film, all my films have been inspired by Mahabharat and Ramayana, because those are the two epics that have been fed into me right from my childhood. So it is not like, okay, let's take one character of Mahabharat and let's put it there. It's not that kind of inspiration. But the emotional connect is, yes, from those epics.
And the film says Bahubali the beginning. So do we expect to see more films in this series?
Yes, it is a two-part film. This is the first part that we are coming with, Bahubali the beginning. The second part will come 1 year later.
राणा मेरा सवाल आपसे है कि जब एक जब बाहुबली शब्द आता है तो उस वक्त दो बहुत ही धुरंधर लोग सामने आते हैं तो आपके सामने ऑलरेडी प्रभास थे तो किस तरीके की तैयारियां आपने खुद के भीतर की क्योंकि पोस्टर में हम देख सकते हैं कि एक तरफ वो खड़े हैं एक तरफ आप खड़े हैं तो बॉडी शॉडी किस तरीके से आपने प्लान किया
What you see right now is actually a shrunken down version of me. I was 25 kilos heavier than this. And and prep went on for about 6 or 8 months, even before we started the film. And yeah, so it was rigorous training, lots of martial arts and all of that. And a special credit to a man called Peter Hens, who did the action of the film. He got a bunch of Vietnamese trainers for both of us, who were living with us for 3 months, didn't speak our language, but just used to whack us and get us up and running.
Rajamouli Karan, see, when I entered the complex, you know, I saw these posters there, you know, and I immediately exclaimed that this world class poster, you know, it looks really world class.
Thank you.
So suddenly I realized that, but here we're not even talking about world class benchmarks, you know, we are still talking about an Indian film, the most expensive Indian film. So is it possible that, when we are dealing with a subject like this, which has such a big canvas, where, you know, we start comparing ourselves or we start thinking in terms of, you know, the world-class benchmarks in terms of filmmaking, this kind of filmmaking. I mean, I've seen films being made in Thailand that have such grand quality and they have these kind of visuals, very impressive war scenes and, you know, and great special effects and all. So when you were making this film and when all of you were working on this project, did you have this kind of a benchmark that this film is going to be one of the best films of this kind, historical or whatever, in the world and will make an impact on the world cinema?
When I start making a film, actually I don't think about what is the end result going to be. No, what drives me to make a film are the emotions in that film. So I try to write the scenes in such a way that connect to me. I actually don't think about how they are connecting to the audience or the world audience or the Telugu audience. I don't think in those terms. So My filmmaking starts from my emotional connect. How do I make these emotions connect to the audience well? Whether let it be the biggest sets or biggest battle sequences, all these things come from the characters. I have a character called Bhallal Deva, who is this larger than life, who has an ego, such an ego that he makes a gold statue of 100 foot high. So such a character, what kind of palace would he live in? That will give me a palace which is 800, which is as tall as an Eiffel Tower. What kind of army will he command? What kind of crown will he wear? No, this character drives me his surroundings. So I make the film in that way. I don't think about what are the world films that are being made. How can we match those standards? No, I don't think in that way. That is one thing. Second thing, I think we think too much of ourselves. We always say we make Hollywood level movies and all that, but I personally feel they are much more ahead of us technically. they're much more ahead of us. And I don't like to be in a rat race in competing with them. They have a head start of 50 to 60 years. They have much more better directors, visionaries, and all that. But only way that we can match with them is with our emotions. I think only emotions-wise, or like we are talking about Mahabharata and Ramayana, the epics we have, these are the only things that we are much, much better than them. But in all other departments, I think they are far ahead of us.
Karan. Karan, yeah. I would like Karan also to respond to the my question. I mean, what is your opinion? I mean, I remember, in Vicky Frames, there was a subject that, are we going to be making, world, $100 million film, $500 million kind of, box office and all, whether we can really, compete with the rest of the world. Now, you have been seeing all kind of films, and you also understand cinema and its business, in terms of, what is the situation of the world, whether it's Hollywood or Chinese film industry or Indian film industry. You're also part of Vicky Frames, you have been part of the committee and all. So from that perspective, I mean, suppose, a film like Bahubali is there. Do you think, we can have, this is our subject, and inspired by, as he said, that inspired by, great stories, epic stories like Mahabharata and Ramayana. Do you think, that we can take all this across and win over the world? I mean, is that possibility exist? And do you visualize yourself doing it?
I have to say that apart from, I think, our cinematic vision and our content, we face a lot of infrastructure obstacles that China does not face. So for example, the growth of China has been phenomenal in the exhibition circuit recently. Just their statistics are just on another level altogether. They're almost competing with Hollywood where it comes to footfalls and it comes to infrastructure. Someone like Anil, I'm sure, will be able to tell you better that we have actually big infrastructure issues when it comes to exhibition. We're still combating number of screens in this country. That's because we have political bureaucracy issues. We have red tape that we're combating. We are one country that are combating many more external forces. Internally, we are prepared. We're ready. We have the infrastructure now. We have some filmmakers who have the vision. We have the technical departments that can enhance that vision. But we don't know have showcasing. We have combating release after release. We have like any multiplex owners will tell you the kind of issues we have with number of screens. So on one level, I think we're prepared. Like to answer your question, yes, we're prepared. We're not here to take on because as Sir just said, that they have a head start. They are way superior to us technically because they have had a head start and they have actually been able to platform that head start and put it out there on celluloid. We're nascent in that department, but let me tell you, we are fast learners and we can catch up really fast and we have the ability. We have so many stories to tell that can integrate Indian mythology with computer graphic cinema, but we have not been able to showcase that. We are still combating sound issues. We're still combating space issues. We're combating a lot of issues that require the information and broadcasting ministry to intervene and enhance us as an industry. We are very crippled. We are either fighting censors or we are fighting screens. We are fighting political issues. Nobody else is fighting those issues that we are fighting on a daily basis. Every day we are fighting FIRs and all this. I mean, every day, if somebody just left Indian cinema alone, we would prosper, but no one leaves us alone. Unfortunately, we are soft targets to everything. A problem anywhere in the world is blamed on us. Everything is something that we are so conscious of. Every little, I keep fearing with every release, now who's going to put a court case on me for something random and ridiculous? So as I said, we are facing a lot of issues that kind of stunt us, stop our growth. Anyway, I think it's been great, but before I think we flag off this wonderful evening, the two lovely ladies here who are both looking fabulous have contributed humongously to Bahubali. I want to know your experience, Anushka, and what's it been like working with a veteran filmmaker?
This is my second movie with Rajmali, sir, and as he said, when we saw, after, of course, working with him in the second movie is, again, a dream come true. I didn't realize when I signed in for the movie, and I remember the first day when we went on set and stood there after listening to the script and listening to how big it was. Never realized how big it was till we stood on that set. We just were lost, in terms of now what do we speak, what do we say? Everything was so big. And then he's always been there to guide us and take us through it. So it's been an amazing journey. And again, I'm someone who always believed in fairy tales and things which are larger than life. And today, I've just seen the trailer, so again, I feel it's a shock to see stories that you read of and what you see as kids and as you're growing up in theaters, to be a part of something like that. And I'm actually looking forward to watch it myself.
And Tamanna, you've of course, I think, working for the very first time. What was your experience?
Honestly, I couldn't even dream that I'm going to be working with Rajamouli sir. And when I came onto the film, they had already finished about 150 days of shooting. And when I went on, when I actually had gone to the set in RFC, just to meet Rana and Sweetie, Anushka. So I just gone to say hello to my friends, and I met Shobhu sir there. And a few days later, I got signed on to Bahubali. For me, working with Rajamouli sir is a very special experience. Not only because he's this amazing filmmaker who makes these big films and makes these amazing films, but the humble person he is and how easy he makes it for his actors to work with him. He actually makes the most difficult to shoot scenes and yet makes it so simple, and it looks like as if it's so approachable and so easy to do. And I've never been inspired by somebody. I didn't want to ever become like someone. I thought I was good enough like myself. But after seeing Rajamouli sir, I want to be like him. Not only in the department of how he, in his professional life, but in his personal life. The way he balances off his family with his work. For me, it's really, really inspiring. And a lesson that I have learned while working on Bahubali. And he's given me a character that I can't even imagine anybody else would imagine me in that kind of a character. It's special, it's memorable. It was challenging every day because it was physically challenging for me because I'd never done action sequences before. So, supposing I have to fight Prabhas, you know how silly that idea could look in my mind because he's like an amazingly tall, handsome looking young man and I have to fight him. So that seemed quite not possible in my head, but of course, because it's Rajamouli sir, everything is possible. Prabhas, I've worked with him before in a film. And his pet name in the Telugu film industry is Darling, by the way, in case nobody knew. Now they know. He's called Darling by the entire film industry and by all his fans. And rightly like his name, he is extremely sweet. And there was one night I remember while I was about to go to shooting the next morning. I had to do some sword fighting, which like I felt like I was as good as holding this mic. I was completely clueless. And Prabhas actually helped me get my move right. And when I shot for it, I could only, you know, secretly thank him for being there for me. I actually knocked at his door and said, can you teach me how to move this sword? I don't know how to move this sword. So he actually taught me. And I'd also like to thank Sendhil sir. Sendhil sir is a cinematographer. As actors, we get time to rest when we are working. We get time off from work and we can sit and chill up in the middle of shots. But two people who don't relax on a film set, one is the director and one is the cinematographer. Sendhil sir, he made me look stunning. I could not believe it's me. And made it, every time I had a small issue, I could go and contact him. He was very, very, very forthcoming and very encouraging when I thought I couldn't do something. So these people mean a lot to me. Sweetie, I've always met her. She's the first heroine in the industry who actually helped me when I entered the film industry. Sorry, I'm taking so long. I just want to talk about all these people. When I entered the film industry, I didn't have a costume designer. I didn't know who to go to for costumes. So Sweetie was the first actress who came up to me, you know what, take my costume designer's number. You know, maybe she can help you. So, you know, it's very rare to see these kind of things, actually. Not many people come to help. So, that's about Sweetie. So, see, their names are Darling and Sweetie. So you can imagine what kind of people they are. The names are just perfectly apt for them. Let me see if I'm missing out. Karan, thank you so much. Without you, this launch could not be as grand as it is. And it couldn't have, for a film like this, nobody better than you. And we were so happy to hear that you're going to present this film. It means the world to us. Thank you. And Shobhu sir, who's this lovely gentleman sitting right next to me, he's the producer of the film. Bahut paise kharch kiye inhone. Aur bahut hi, bahut zyada mehnat kiye inhone. I think we've all become such good friends on the, sounds so cliche, sorry, but we've just become really good friends on the film set. And I've forgotten about Rana, okay. Rana, The day I went on the film set, that first day when I wasn't on the film, I felt like a little dwarf next to him. I felt like a little puny little thing. And that's how when he says that he was 25 kgs over what he's right now. So I felt like this. I was like, okay, Rana, good to have you, seeing you after really long. So yeah. He as Balala Deva, he is insane. He's extremely good looking, and the acting, of course, is something that people will watch. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
All right, so we're gonna just very quickly just last two questions now.
No, 1 minute. Firstly, thank you, Tamanna, for being the master of ceremonies today. And I really think that you found yourself an alternate profession, but you were wonderful and as gracious and sweet as you are. We're actually going to, I just feel that you can tell the love, because imagine Hindi film industry doesn't have a sweetie or a darling at all. I think we also, our stars should also start giving in themselves these names, because it would just lead to the camaraderie. Very quickly, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like the producers to definitely have the final word, because I think without their support, like I said right at the start of this evening, that it takes a lot of courage for people to put their lives and their economics on this kind of vision. And I think no director is complete without the support of a producer. Shobhu, as I said, was the first gentleman I met after Rana on Bahubali. And thank you, Shobhu. And I'd like for you to just share your experience.
Hello, everyone. First of all, thanks, Karan, for having us here and present in the film. With regards to Bahubali, last 3-4 years have been, for me, nothing but Bahubali. I've been completely involved with the project, and it's been day and night with it. And when you're working with some very passionate people and some very committed people like Rajmouli and the rest of the team and rest of the cast, it's really a joy and it's a pleasure to be working, and we've learned so much in the entire thing. And I think and I hope this project will be a good success. Thank you.
And Prasad, with love, please say something. Say hello.
I'd like to thank Karan, Anil and the team at Dharma for presenting the film, and we need your support to take this film national. Thank you.
And Anil would like to sing a song now, right?
Yes. From student number
one. From student number one.
It's always been amazing working with Karan, and now it's been even a better privilege to be working with Rajmouli and Prasad and Shobhu. So thanks for this opportunity, and I hope your vision and the success that you've thought of comes true.
Well, thank you. I'd like to thank everybody here. We're going to call this now. We're going to come to a close for this evening. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. You've come in such large numbers. And I know you've come because you believe in cinema more than anything else. And I think that's what we're all here for. We're here really to push the envelope when it comes to cinema. So thank you for joining us. And thank you, sir. Thank you, Rajmouli, sir. Thank you for being a part of cinema and for making us all feel so proud today. Thank you very much.
Can I ask one question from Prabhas?
You're saying so sweetly, ask that one last. If you call him darling, then only.
Okay, he's like my son. I can call him darling.
Okay.
Karan, Prabhas.
Karan, one more question to Prabhas, please. Karan,
After me.
Yes, after her.
Okay, Prabhas, since he's the presenter, Karan is the presenter of the film, and has he promised you a role? And also, does this mean to say that you are ready to give a tough competition to all the other Bollywood heroes and saying that Prabhas is here? Comment.
No, I didn't think so much like tough competition. Well, that's too much now. And what was the other question you asked? No, he didn't promise me anything.
I'm here. One question to, anyhow, he's holding the mic. One question to Prabhas, please. I'm Prema from TV5 again. Prabhas and Balala Deva and Bahubali, I just have one question to both of you. 3 years you spent your time on Bahubali. And was it really a pressure on your head? Did at any point of time you felt that, oh God, can we continue like this for some more years? And was it possible? Was somewhere you felt it was not possible?
Yeah, like maybe they shot with me in 380 or 50, I don't know. They shot with me more than nearly 300 days. After 250 days, I really got frustrated. Now I was like, Raj, I want to say, I didn't tell him, but Raj, now it's enough. We'll see, we'll watch the film. whatever it's done, just show it. Yeah, one second.
Well, first time he told me the story and I knew I had to give a large part of time and I was not the hero of the film also. But then one thing I knew was this is the largest thing in cinema that I'd ever be part of. And I didn't know if anyone will ever make a film like this again. So which is why every day was a pleasure.
Yes, on my left. हे भगवान मैं बस हे भगवान कहके मैं हाथ जोड़ के विनती करता हूँ मुझे शुद्धि के बारे में पूछना बंद करो पता नहीं किस किस्म का नजर लग चुका है इस फिल्म पे वो पिक्चर बनी ही नहीं क्योंकि सवाल का जवाब दे दे के मैं थक चुका आप लोग थकते नहीं क्या जब जब शुद्धि का मैं पोस्टर अनाउंस करूंगा ना तब उसके बारे में बात होगी मैं स्पेशली आई एम गोइंग टू हैव अ पोस्टर डिजाइन टू शो के एक्चुअली इट्स अ रियलिटी एंड इट्स नॉट अ मिथ थैंक यू वेरी मच लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन